In the last video, we have seen the calculation of steel quantity for this given roof truss. In this video, we are going to calculate the painting quantity. If you want to calculate the painting of one angle section, so let me explain. If you see this angle section, let us assume the size of this angle as this length is 75 and this depth is 50 mm for example. So this angle section has to be painted on outer face as well as inner face. So this outer face, if you want to calculate, this length will be 75 mm plus this length will be 50 mm. Then next, if you want to calculate this inner face now. So from this edge till this and this top edge, if you consider, this will be 75 mm. Then next, this vertical face plus this bottom edge, if you consider, it will be 50 mm. So therefore, how do you calculate? 75 multiplied by 2, 50 multiplied by 2. In this way, we are going to calculate the breadth of painting that has to be done in the angle section. So let's calculate now. Already we have done calculation for principal rafter. If you see the previous video, we have calculated the numbers and length. Length will remain same, only the breadth has to be added. So the unit of measurement of painting is square meters. So breadth has to be added. Now how do you calculate the breadth? As I had said earlier, as this angle is 75 by 50. So therefore this is 75 multiplied by 2 plus 50 multiplied by 2. So that will be equal to 250 mm, that is 0.25 meters. So therefore breadth is 0.25 meters, 7.6 multiplied by 0.25. So as it is a double angle, left side, if you see this figure, this is a double angle, so two angles here we have, on right side we have two angles, so therefore totally four numbers. Earlier what we had calculated, this number and length will remain same, only breadth is going to change. So only breadth has to be added. So we have calculated, very simple, it is 0.25 meters. That is 4 multiplied by 7.6 multiplied by 0.25, you will get quantity as 7.6 meters. Similarly, we are going to do calculation for all the other angle sections. So, numbers will remain same, length will remain same, only breadth has to be added. Similarly, if we calculate 75 into 2 plus 50 into 2, so it will be 250 mm, that is 0.25 meters. Next, for strut, if you want to calculate, 65 into 2 plus 45 into 2, it will be 220 mm, that is 0.22 meters. If you multiply, we are going to get the quantities. Similarly, for all the angle sections, we have calculated. In the previous video, what we have written, these things will remain same. These things will remain same, only breadth we have added extra. Breadth we have added. Next is, when you go for this flat plate sections, flat sections, it is 50 by 8. So for example, only if you consider this one single leg, if you have a plate, so this is 50 mm, back side we have 50 mm. So two sides, 50 into 2 has to be done, this top is 8, bottom is 8, 8 into 2. In that way, we are going to calculate for flat plates. That is 50 into 2 is 100 plus 8 into 2, 16. 100 plus 16, it is 116 mm. So number and length will remain same, only breadth has been added. If you multiply, you will get the answer. Similarly, this also, 80 into 2, 116 plus 6 into 2, 112. It will be 172 mm. If you multiply, you will get the answer. Similarly, for these tie members, we are going to calculate. So next is, we will calculate for the gusset plates. So if you see this gusset plate we have, first we'll start with this apex plate. Size of this plate is 75 cm by 45 cm. Already this area we have calculated. Area of the gusset plate already we have calculated. But only front face we have calculated. On back side also painting has to be done. So therefore one single plate will be multiplied by 2. Because two faces painting has to be done. If you see the previous video, we had written 0.75 by 0.45. This already we have written. Previously number was 1. only one area we had calculated, but in the painting on both the faces painting has to be done, so therefore it will be two numbers at base. Similarly, we had two numbers, we will multiply it by 2, therefore it will be 4 numbers. These dimensions will remain same. Already we have written these dimensions. What all numbers we had written in the previous video, it will be multiplied by 2. So this was 2 numbers, multiplied it by 2. This was 4 numbers, multiplied by 2. Similarly, if you go on multiplying for 2 faces, you will get these numbers. These dimensions will remain same. If you multiply 4 by 0.3 by 0.3, it will get answer as 0.36. If you add up all the quantity, you will get painting quantity for one truss, that is 19.68 square meters. Next is, we have calculated for one truss, we will multiply it by 5, so as to get the quantity for 5 trusses. If you multiply by 5 multiplied by 19.68, it will be 98.4 square meters. Next is, we'll calculate for purlins. So purlin, again same thing, 12 numbers we had. So 125 into 2 plus 75 into 2, it will be 400 mm. So we have multiplied it by breadth. For the angle section, we'll get this quantity. For wind tie, it is 32 multiplied by 2. Plus 6 multiplied by 2, it is 76 mm, we have multiplied here. So if you multiply, you will get the answer. If you add up all this quantity, we are going to get the quantity for all the 5 trusses. So this completes the painting quantity. Then next comes is GI sheet. So now we will calculate for GI sheeting. If you see the figure, if you see this joint details, we have the principal rafter, above that we have purlins, above that GI sheeting is being fixed. So this quantity has to be calculated now. If you see the figure, here they have given the length of the GI sheeting as 7.8 meters on one side, that is left side. Similarly, we have on right side. So therefore, numbers will be 2. Therefore, 2 numbers we have. Next is, we have to take the length. So clear span is 21 meters. We will take bearing 150 mm on left side, 150 mm on right side. Therefore, it will be 21.3 meters. We have 21.3 meters. Next comes is breadth. Breadth is 7.8 meters. Already it is being given. We will multiply it by 7.8. So, we are going to get the area of the GI sheetings. Next comes is GI ridging, which is being calculated in running meters. If you see this GI sheeting, above this there is one GI ridging, which is we have 25 centimeters. Now length of this GI ridging has to be calculated, which is measured in running meters. Only length has to be calculated. Again same thing, clear span is 21 meters plus bearing, it will be 21.3 meters. So one number, it will be at center, therefore it is one number, length is 21.3. So therefore quantity will be 21.3 meters. So, these are the quantities which we have calculated. So, as to prepare an abstract sheet, this quantity has to be multiplied by the rates so as to get the cost. If you sum up all the cost, you will get the total cost of the truss. Thank you.